Hi, Cloud Gurus. I'm Elle Marquez, and welcome to Linux This Month, the show that gives you the latest and most important news in the Linux world. Today, we'll be covering the latest updates and security patches to the Android open source project, along with some fun news for Tux, our beloved Linux penguin. From there, we're going to move on to changes announced with the release of GNOME 3.8 and the general release of BottleRocket OS. But before we delve in, let's take a look at this month's noteworthy news. So grab your man pages and let's jump on in. Google's Android 11 has released on September 8th, 2020, and now offers additional benefits to enterprise clients. The introduction of asset management and personal use policies means that IT teams will be able to ensure devices are in compliance with corporate policy while still being able to maintain employees' privacy. September's 2020 security patches are out. Google has published the September 2020 security bulletin. It contains details on security vulnerabilities that have been discovered on the Android open source framework, the Linux kernel, and chips from vendors. Now, as a Linux and security enthusiast, I want to emphasize the importance of staying up to date with your device's security patches. So if you're a Google Pixel owner, go check out the September's release, and select Samsung devices have also been offered updates. Others will come based on vendor schedule. Looking to have a little fun this month? Well, Tux, our beloved Linux penguin, is getting his debut in a free and open source game, Super Tux Kart. Try saying that one three times fast. Anyways, Super Tux Kart is a 3D kart racing game. It's based on the 2000s Tux Kart game and includes a variety of characters, tracks, and different modes of play. It even has team chat. It's available free on Windows, Mac OS, Linux, and mobile OS, with game creation of racing servers available on iOS devices. Zorin OS 15.3 is here. Zorin OS 15.3 has been released and is based on Ubuntu's 18.04.5 LTS release. Although Zorin was first released in July 2019, it's already reported over 1.7 million downloads, with a majority of these downloads from Windows and Mac users. The release comes with a new Linux kernel, and it should give users better system performance, greater security, and improved hardware compatibility, like compatibility with Intel's recently announced 11th generation CPUs and upcoming AMD processors. GNOME 3.38 is here. The latest release of GNOME 3, GNOME 3.38, has been codenamed Orbis, and it was released on September 16th. The release includes 6 months of updates, which may not seem like a lot until you realize it incorporates 27,896 changes made by approximately 901 contributors. Several core utilities have been updated, giving the overall look of the desktop environment an elegant appearance. Some notable updates are improved screen recording, better multi-monitor support, and my favorite virtualization software, Boxes, now allows editing of virtual machines libvirt XML. This enables you to change advanced settings and to be able to configure an environment as you want. Red Hat and IBM have announced a hybrid cloud software marketplace. Red Hat has partnered with parent company IBM to announce the general availability release of their new hybrid software marketplace. Now, as we continue to see the growth of applications being built on the cloud, there are more and more choices, leading to more and more layers of complexity. Developers are currently expected to build within a CI/CD DevOps environment, and they have to have software that has been pre-approved for purchase. Now, these purchases also have to have hardware and software that have been approved for security and compliance, and really, they have to ensure that applications are enterprise-grade, they're scalable, and they're cloud-native. Red Hat and IBM are looking to help tackle this while still giving companies and developers, and yes, even us tinkerers, the flexibility in application choice, and the choice to which cloud provider we will deploy. Marketplace will make it easier for developers and companies to have a one-stop shop to buy and deploy container-based software. Software offerings such as Sysdig and MongoDB are all provided by independent vendors and their certified OpenShift offerings, which are built on Kubernetes operating framework, allowing them to run just like if they were cloud services, enabling the ability to be able to do automated upgrades, backups, failover, and recovery. Marketplace also offers a personalized marketplace experience through Red Hat Marketplace Select at an additional cost. This allows companies to have greater control to pre-approve software that meets their current policies and governance. In March, Amazon announced the developer preview release of BottleRocket OS, its very own open source Linux distribution, built specifically to run containers on virtual machines or bare metal. Basically, it's a minimalistic Linux distribution, and it contains only the software needed to run in containers, and it uses the open source standard components. That was March, and now is September. So BottleRocket has been made generally available, making it the default operating system for Amazon EKS and ECS. With BottleRocket as the default OS for EKS and ECS, it will be covered under the AWS support plan and be able to take advantages of certified BottleRocket partners, all through the APN partner network. Now, I understand that there are other container OSs available. However, BottleRocket updates are their main differentiator, with updates being received through one single step updates instead of the traditional Linux package by package updates. BottleRocket also offers the ability to configure changes manually through an API call. This allows easy automation using container orchestration. It makes it easy to automate through Amazon Elastic Container Services or Amazon Elastic Service. There are heaps of other benefits, but I can't go through them all. So check out the link available in the resources below. But I highly recommend that you give BottleRocket a try. It's now GA, so no cost on the Amazon machine images within EC2. Or you can fork BottleRocket's project on GitHub and give it a whirl within your own environment. That's it for this month. We'll see you in November with more updates on Linux this month. Now, what are you waiting for? Go have a little fun with SuperTuxCart. Until then, keep being awesome, cloud gurus.